Don't miss out on the special offer from my sponsor, Buy Madden Coins. They're currently giving you 20% off if you use my coupon code POODLE at checkout, and also giving you an additional 10% coins at checkout. Hey, what's going on, everybody? It's Poodle back with another Madden Ultimate Team video, guys. And today, I'm going to be showing you guys how to get a free 89 to 90 overall player. Now, if you haven't heard how to yet already, it's pretty simple. But I'm also going to be ranking those players so you can pick the best one. I'm not sure if it's fantasy or it's just a randomized. If it's randomized, I'll tell you which one I like the best so you guys have an idea of why which ones are the best. And then I'll tell you if it's fantasy, which one to pick, which is very helpful. Now, guys, it's pretty cool. This content just dropped last night at midnight for the launch. So a lot of you might not actually know because, again, it was midnight. It came out really late last night. So in case you don't know, this will be very useful for you guys. Now, also, if you're new to the channel, make sure to drop a sub. Helps a lot. We've been growing rapidly over the last few days for a small channel, and I'm really loving it. And also, let's get this video to 100 likes. We've been hitting the like goal recently, so I'm loving all that. Thank you for all the support. And also, comment down below who's your favorite one of the 89s and 90s, and if you plan to do these, and which one you're going to take. Let me know down below. I obviously have my opinion. Now, guys, if you didn't know what I'm talking about, it's the 89 to 90 superstar players. Now, they just dropped last night. All these bundles dropped for them and everything, which is kind of lowering their price just a bit for now, but the bundles are kind of trash, in my opinion. I don't think I touch them. They're more so like the Hall of Fame promo last year, where you're pretty much just going for a Hall of Fame player to do the sets. Now, you guys already know, I picked up the Mahomes. I was not waiting for that. You see him right there. So you kind of know my favorite player, but Mahomes is a beast. Comes pre-chemmed up, pre-abilityed up, stud quarterback. I was not waiting any longer for him. I bought him for like 382, which is kind of like overpriced for what he should be going for. I mean, I think he's worth it, but the market says he should be cheaper than that. Now, I'm going to go into the set real quick to show you guys which ones I would take. And I'll show you exactly where to go to get them. So there's Mahomes, there's Zach Ertz, Stephon Gilmore, and Harrison Smith. Now, all four of these guys are amazing. Now, if I had to rank them, I'm not going by overall here, although it's going to seem like it, because it just so happens that that's how it's going to look. I'm not really a fan of some here, but they're all really good. I just wouldn't use all of them. So coming in at last for me on this list is Zach Ertz. Now, I'm going to take guys to the auction block to show you their stats, so understand why I don't like Zach Ertz. You know what the issue is? It's just that I'm not a fan of the tight ends this year in this Madden just because of how slow they are. That's why, like, George Kittle is just a difference maker at tight end just based off his speed. So I'm going to take guys to superstar right here and show you Zach Ertz. You understand? His catching's amazing. Like, he's practically, like, he'd be the best wide receiver in the game. It's just, like, a really slow one. Take a look at that. 91 catching, 88 catch in traffic, 87 spec catch, 89 short route running, 86 medium route running. But his run block is bad and his 78 speed. I'd much rather have my George Kittle. In my opinion, he's faster. He can run block and catch decently. Although Zach Ertz would catch everything, I don't like slow tight ends. It's like having another lineman out there. Now, coming in second on this list is going to be Harrison Smith. Like I said, it's going to look like the order of 89s first and 90s. Harrison Smith is an amazing strong safety, like probably one of the best in the game. The only issue is his speed. So listen to everything else. He has 81 tackle, good. 92 play rec, amazing. 88 pursuit, amazing. 89 zone, amazing. 87 hit power, amazing. 79 man for a strong safety, really good. But an 81 speed, which is hard when you have players like Ken Houston. Just look how fast he is. Like, he's all over the field, even if his stats aren't the same. Now, for that reason, I'd put Harrison Smith in third, though. He's still not bad. But these 90 overall cards, I'm going more in depth on. They're crazy, crazy good. So we got Stephon Gilmore and Patrick Mahomes. For some reason, Mahomes is cheaper than Gilmore. But coming in at third is going to be Stephon Gilmore. I mean, don't get me wrong. He's a monster. But I'm a massive Pat Mahomes fan. He's going to be the best quarterback in the game. So, you know, kind of gives you a consensus number one. But let me explain them real quick. So Stephon Gilmore has 85 speed, 88 excel, 88 agility, 84 jumping, 89 play rec, 92 man, 83 zone, 88 press. So if you chem this guy up, he has above a 90 press, a medium, like a 95 man, an 85 zone. His speed's an 85. You power him up, he's gonna be 86. His excel's about to break 90. His agility's about to break 90. Like, these are stats like you should see in a corner like in a month, like not now. His stats are insane. There's no other way around it. And he's also 6'1". Let's see what his catching is. His catching is 68, which isn't bad at this point in the game. And let's see what his hip power is. I know it's not gonna be that good. What's his block shed? 46 is a little low, but he has a corner. Hit power 62, that's not bad either for a corner. So coming at number one, Patrick Mahomes. guys. He speaks for himself. His throw power, if you put Go Deep on him, is a 90. His throw accuracy short could break the threshold. His medium accuracy is 85. His accuracy deep is 86. His throw under pressure is 89, which is really big. Because this year, pressure is insane coming off the edge. A lot better pass rushers this year, or at least it plays a lot better. So, a lot of quarterbacks make very erratic throws right now due to having bad throw under pressure. His throw on the run is also a 90. And he has a 75 speed, which right now would equate as like one of the fastest elite quarterbacks, considering Cam Newton's and all those guys all have like 75, 73 speeds too, and Russell Wilson. So he's crazy fast for a quarterback right now at this point in the game. Obviously, there's Kyler Murray, but like he can't throw. But that's about it for my ranking, Jazz. Let me show you guys where to get this and how to get this. You guys are probably a bit confused right now on how to get it because it's not exactly the most self-explanatory. But playing Madden in the past, I kind of understand how this trend goes. So you go over to the Mutt Superstars, you go into Challenges, Mutt Superstars, and as per usual, look at the milestones to see how you get things. So Tier 1, you get an 84 to 85 overall in that Superstar Fantasy Pack. That is huge. By the way, I could rank the players in there in a separate video if you guys want, but personally, just letting you guys know in this video, if you're watching, I like Philip Lindsay. 86 speed running back, budget beast for free. Take his ass. That's literally the best running back right now. Him and Tariq Cohen and Marcus Allen. I used them for one game. He broke loose for like 130 yards. Definitely a monster. Anyways, Tier 2, 89 to 90 overall in that Superstar Master Pack. That is crazy. We're getting a free 89 to 90 Superstar Master 300K card. Unless you get the 89s, then 200-something K card. And then Tier 3, 175 stars for 277 to 78 gold Superstar player, which is kind of dumb in my opinion, but I guess it's just a little extra for you. But this one takes 145 stars. So you might be wondering, okay, so is there enough stars to complete this? There is not. There is the Mutt Superstars. There is a grand total of 80 stars to be had. So first off on this one, you have to get 5 stars on every single challenge. You have 80 stars, right? So you do all of these. They're pretty simple. They're like the journey, you know, they're moment challenges. So you do all these. They're all in the fourth quarter for the most part. You end up with 80 stars. So you're still short by approximately 65 stars. So now there's the daily superstar challenges. These allow you to get up to 5 stars per day. So you need 65 stars. I'm pretty sure. Let me go do the math just to not sound dumb here. You get 80 stars and then you're going to need, 65 more stars. So the daily superstar challenge will be 5 per day. So you're going to need 65 is going to be, how much is that? 60, it's 6, 12. It's going to be like 13. You're going to need to wait like 13 more days, technically 14. If my math is right, because 12 days times 5 would be 60. And then you need 65, so that is 13 days. So you're going to have to play 13 of these, so you won't be able to get it for another 13 days. But guys, that doesn't matter. So you have one of the best cards, if not the best cards in the game right now, for free, and all you have to do is wait 13 days. That is a deal in my book. That's a deal. I'm doing that all day of the week. These challenges are very, very, very easy. Daily superstar challenge is very easy. They level you up. By the way, guys, I'm almost level 50, so be expecting my legend pack soon. Probably if they drop 1030 content for legends, I will probably be dropping it in that video, because it would just make sense to show off the legends and do a little pack and see if I can pull in a limited times. But guys, that's about it for this video. I hope you guys enjoyed. I hope you guys make the right choice. Now, I'm not entirely sure if it's Nat. I know it's Nat. By the way, it's Nat. But I didn't mention that. But I'm not entirely sure if you can pick what you get. It doesn't say. So if you could pick, remember. Zach Ertz. Harrison Smith. Stephon Gilmore. Patrick Mahomes, in my opinion. If you guys don't like Nat quarterbacks, which is entirely understandable, then go Stephon Gilmore. It all depends, right? But the 84 or 85 over on that pack, don't forget, guys. Philip Lindsay is a beast. Anthony Barr's pretty good. That's about all I can remember that was actually good out of that pack. But Philip Lindsay, 86 speed running back, that's a glitch right now. That's Marcus Allen level. That's Tariq Cohen level. I just recommend you take advantage of that glitchiness. But yeah, if you guys have been enjoying the content, make sure to smash the like button. Let's get 100 likes in this video. We've been blowing up the like button. For us, at least, that's really good. I really appreciate that, guys. And also, make sure to subscribe. Go down below, hit the sub button, hit the bell noty button, whatever you want to call it. Get notified every time I post a new video, which is going to be big for daily content drops and coin methods and how to do things and tips and everything I do. Because if you get notified right away, you can get on it quickly. And when you can get on things quickly, you make more coins in this game. That's about it, guys. Don't forget to comment down below. who you got out of this nat pack when you do, or who you intend to get out of my rankings. Or if you think, if you disagree with my rankings, tell me down below. I don't mind refuting it and talking about it, and maybe even changing my mind on who I should take. But that's it, guys. I'm out. See you guys in the next video. Peace.